In this illustration, we'll analyze the Lyman spectral line after Balmer spectral line in hydrogen spectrum. The illustration says it is observed that always after emission of a photon in Balmer series from hydrogen atom, it is followed by a photon or Lyman series, and we are required to find the wavelength of the second photon. Now, in this situation, we know well, when we talk about Balmer series, then Balmer series spectral line is emitted for a transition. Here we can write when any N2 value to transition takes place at N1 is equals to 2. This is the higher energy level and this is the lower energy level. Whenever a transition from higher orbit to second energy level takes place, then the spectral line emitted will fall in Balmer series. And certainly when an electron drops to N equals to 2, this implies we can write after emission of Balmer spectral line, after emission of we can write any Balmer spectral line, electron will further de-excite from N equals to 2 to N equals to 1, because it is already in N equals to 2 and 1 is vacant in hydrogen. So it will further de-excite from 2 to 1. This implies the next photon energy emitted is, this is corresponding to E2 minus E1, which is, we can write energy of second energy level is minus 3.4 electron volt minus or minus 13.6 electron volt, which is 10.2 electron volt. As the second photon, which is always emitted after any Balmer spectral line, this falls in Lyman series. So this N equals to 2 to N equals to 1 is a Lyman spectral line. In fact, this is the first line of Lyman series for 2 to 1. As we know, from any higher orbit to N equals to 1, when electron de-excites for this transition, the spectral line emitted is considered to be in Lyman series. So, if we calculate the wavelength for this energy, and this lambda corresponding to 2 to 1 transition, we can write this 12431 by 10.2. Numerically, this gives us 12187.73 angstrom, which is the result of this problem.